Welcome again. In the previous videos of this module, we have talked about business aspects of autonomous electric vehicles and smart charging. Today we will discuss advanced business aspects of another important technology, vehicle-to-grid, or to be more general, vehicle-to-everything, or vehicle-to-X. Can you guess how many hours per day an average car is parked at home or at the office? The answer is 22 hours. Surprising, right? Most vehicles remain idle for most of the day. But what if we come up with a smart solution? Let's say you could charge your car battery during the afternoon, when electricity is cheap and plentiful. And during the evening, when demand and prices are high, you could supply this stored electricity to the grid or use it to run appliances at home. What we need to achieve this is the ability to extract power from the car battery. This is exactly what Vehicle2X does. This means it's earning money for you while you work or sleep. But what happens when cars are shared? Or when they become autonomous? They would not be standing still as often. Well, this is true. Car sharing and autonomous driving will certainly ensure that vehicles are utilized better. However, a study by McKinsey shows that even by 2030, only 1 in 10 cars sold will be potentially a shared vehicle. A similar thing is true for autonomous cars. So in next decades, there will still be lots of cars, electric cars, that will be standing still. This means there is an opportunity to use them in a smart way and earn money with your connected car. That is what we will discuss in this section. Vehicle-to-grid may change EVs from a problem to the grid into a possible provider of grid solutions as a flexible asset. They could be a solution to many issues the grid will face during the energy transition. Within an energy system, powered by renewable storage solutions such as batteries, will become an essential piece of the puzzle. So what if we can use the electric cars for this? In fact, they are just the big batteries on wheels. This way, we do not need to invest in extra and expensive stationary batteries for your home or office, thus saving you money. What you see here is a simple diagram that shows how the car can be interconnected and provide power and value to the grid. There are 3 levels what we distinguish. However, to understand this, we need to first understand the function of an aggregator, the central player in the Vehicle2X framework. The aggregator is responsible for acquiring flexibility from customers who do not only consume electricity, but also may produce it. An aggregator can pay customers for a fee, reducing their electricity consumption during peak hours. Once the aggregator has a sufficient number of customers, it can sell this flexibility to a transmission system operator, TSO, as shown in the figure. V2G can also manifest itself on a local level to balance loads on the DSO low voltage grid, or at a building level where EVs are connected behind the meter of a building. What we've learned about smart charging in the previous sections, and in fact smart charging and Vehicle2X are quite similar. So you might ask, what are the additional capabilities of Vehicle2X? Well, these include the following. Because the car can now discharge energy into the grid, it can serve as a backup power source for a building in case of a blackout or grid failure. And it can be used as storage of locally produced solar energy to be used later that same day. On a DSO level, the electric car can be discharging electricity to the grid, reduce peak powers on the low voltage grid caused by other loads, such as, for example, heat pumps. And it can be used to mitigate power quality issues. But since this is the business track, I will not explain this in more detail. And lastly, the case for vehicle-to-grid for the TSO. This is a bit more difficult, so I will explain this on the following slide. On this slide, you see the difference between smart charging, or V1G, and V2G. In the case of V2G, because the car can now also discharge, the maximum flexible power capacity of the car is doubled. The other important difference is the duration that the car can supply the service. With V2G, the vehicle can constantly provide a service to the grid when it is plugged in. In the case of smart charging, or V1G, the EV can only provide a service when it is actively charging. Because when the car's battery is fully charged, it might still be connected, but it cannot be used as a flexible load anymore. So this means that with V2G, we can earn a lot more money with our electric car than with regular smart charging. But there's another possibility to even further increase the value per car. What we can do is supply a number of different services to multiple different actors. This is called stacking of services. It allows us to create value by trading on the energy markets and buying electricity at the cheapest price, and by supplying services to the DSO, the TSO, and for example, the office building. So by enabling V2G, the possible revenues are much higher than the benefits in case of smart charging. These can go as high as, and possibly even over, 1,000 euros per EV per year. However, it should be noted that these are revenues and do not equal the profits. This is because there are additional costs to enable vehicle-to-grid to work. This can be quite complex and therefore costly. Extra costs include the cost of a special bidirectional charger, additional energy loss, and extra aggregation, communication, and back-end costs. And as with any new technology, many barriers are encountered in the implementation of V2G as a business. On the technical side, the cost of the hardware for implementing Vehicle2X is high. It is expected that as technology evolves with time and demand volume grows, the prices will come down. Yet it remains to be seen if this will make the Vehicle2X business profitable. Also, it is still not completely clear to what extent Vehicle2X may degrade batteries due to extra charge and discharge cycles. These extra cycles mean, with the current tech system, that both outgoing and incoming energy streams are taxed. Obviously, this affects the business case in a negative way. But governments may be willing to exempt V2G charging from this double taxation. And in this previous section, we've seen that net metering and feed-in tariffs lower the value of local storage and thus V2G. And lastly, an important part of implementing V2G is to understand, predict, and control the behavior of consumers. Because you need to know when the car is available to supply the service to the grid. This also remains a challenge. So V2X technology and its business cases are still in its development stage. But currently, many pilot projects in many different countries are deployed to see if the technology can work on a practical scale, to understand consumer behavior, and to understand difficulties in implementation. This slide gives you an example of Vehicle2X projects taking place around the world and the main differences between them. As you can see, most of these projects are currently in the process of implementation. The Parker project in Denmark is an extension of earlier smart charging projects and will look to evaluate the various EV capabilities and their usefulness for the grid. The FCR project in the Netherlands looks to commercialize V2G by applying it to decentralized frequency control of the grid. In Japan, the Toyota City project aims to balance the load by supplying power on a large scale from EVs. I would like to conclude this lecture by telling you about the Lombok's V2G pilot in the Netherlands, which is being implemented by a consortium of Renault, Utrecht City Council, Elaat and Lomboxnet. Their aim is to develop a framework for smart solar charging and show the potential of vehicle-to-grid in real life. In the initial phase of the project, the pilot will have 40 EVs and 20 chargers. If the initial phase is successful, the project may expand to 1,000 shared EVs, 1,000 chargers and 10,000 new installed solar panels. So we expect to see much more of this promising technology in the future. Thank you very much for your attention.